about Dame Keiko, alias Keidame, never asked for any of this, for her powers was an inheritance from a lineage which she was a part of, which had been in existence for generations, in which the woman in her family had the ability to invoke ancient Japanese folklores to existence to come to their aid. Keidame viewed her powers as a burden at first in her early life, but as she grew older, she began to appreciate her powers by using it to help people in trouble. Keidame was tired of losing those who were close to her, for as we know, losing a loved one can be devastating, especially ones that are untimely and unexpected. She was tired of being afraid and scared. Volt is dead and was buried at the same site as his compatriots in the Paradigm. No matter how hard Qubit tried to convince Keidame to leave for the fear of the Plutonian, she wanted to stay and mourn her friend, for she cared less about the Plutonian. Now, let's not forget that Qubit still has the bullet that can end the Plutonian's life, with no one knowing the wiser. And for some reason that is only understandable to Qubit, he doesn't want to kill the Plutonian for now. To be candid, he also have our hero survivor to worry about, for he believes his newfound powers and confidence have made him a bit of a backside, and he can't differentiate between him and the Plutonian, for they are both out of their minds. The only positive thing at the moment is that our hero survivor is still a part of the Team Paradigm, which he is now the self-appointed leader. For the fear of the Plutonian, the real name of Volt couldn't be carved on his tombstone, for he might go after his relatives and kill them just to prove a nefarious point in which he had done to some of his teammates in the Paradigm that he killed. As Qubit consoles Keidame, he asked her to tell him tales about Volt, in which she interjected that there was nothing she can talk about that Qubit doesn't know about. But Qubit insisted that Keidame should tell him about Volt like he was a stranger, and she obliged. Gilgamesh was lost in thought into the abyss, as his mind flows to an endless stream of thoughts, for he was heartbroken. His heart was shattered beyond despair, for he heard everything his wife told the late Orion before being captured by the military, on how he was predictable, old-fashioned, too open-hearted, which made him less exciting. Ouch! That reality would tear any man's heart to shreds, even for a man like Gilgamesh, whom had lived for centuries. What was more painful was that his wife Betinor slept with a man he held in high regards, a friend. It was a closed chapter, not because he fell out of love for his wife, as if that was easy, but because his wife Betinor was nowhere to be found, due to guilt and shame for jilting her husband. And also, she blames herself for not being honest at the beginning of the Plutonian's rampage about the bullet she made out of the candle wax that could have killed him. As Gilgamesh, in sadness, drifted into the wilderness to an endless path, our hero survivor, who is still enraged and furious that the Plutonian was still alive, crashed into a hidden military base of the country, held the acting commander-in-chief, whom was part of the element in the government that summoned the late Orion to hunt them down, and demanded for the body of his late brother, in which the acting commander-in-chief told him that they weren't aware that Scylla was dead. Now, the acting commander-in-chief was surprised at how Survivor found their secret base, but thanks to Qubit, whom gave Survivor the location and schematics of the military base, when he was almost about to beat Qubit to a pulp. With his powers, he destroyed all controls of the nuclear arsenals, which took years to build, and let the acting commander-in-chief know that he and his teammates are now in charge and must be treated with respect. In the media, there was a sighting of the Plutonian. More shocking to them, Samsara was with him, whom he murdered, for everyone was confused. Now, for some reason best known to Samsara, whom is being inhabited by Modius, was meditating in the middle of the road, and his act caused a car accident, which in all honesty, the driver, Brian, wasn't looking at where he was going, for he was trying to stop his daughter, whom was sitting at the back of the car, from watching the news about the Plutonian. But unfortunately, his car flipped over and crashed, which resulted in the death of his daughter and the injury to his wife, whom was sitting next to him. To make matters matters worse for Brian, the car burst into flames and he was helpless as Samsara, whom is being inhabited by Modius, stood by without giving any help. He just stood by and watched. The Plutonian was not around at this time, but he heard the cry of Brian and used his breath to quench the fire and asked if Samsara, alias Modius, was fine, in which Samsara lied to the Plutonian that he tried to help but he was too late. The Plutonian told Brian that his daughter is dead and his wife's spine is shattered. While Brian was wailing in regret, blaming himself for the accident, the Plutonian, in a calm demeanor, asked Brian if he will forgive himself if given a second chance by telling Brian that he can reverse his predicament. Now, this question was shocking to Samsara, who was inhabited by Modius. For since the Plutonian had gone bonkers, he had never shown mercy, not even for once. But in the end, the Plutonian told hopeful Brian that he can't, letting Brian know that mistakes are unforgivable and can't be reversed, in which made Samsara, alias Modius, become curious of the Plutonian's perspective. Is the Plutonian talking about himself? Is the Plutonian feeling remorseful for his atrocities to humanity? Now, Kaidan was not only talking about Volt, but other late members of the Paradigm that the Plutonian killed and murdered, excluding Volt, who was killed by Samsara, who is inhabited by Modius. But the truth is that Qubit was helping Kaidan mentally to harness and expound her powers beyond invoking ancient spiritual folklores by preparing her for the next confrontation with the Plutonian, as Qubit made her realize that her talking about her late Paradigm members had invoked their spirit to reality. As the paramedics took Brian and his family away, a curious Samsara, whom is being inhabited by Modius, asked the Plutonian what he wants. Without even giving it a thought, he replied that he can have anything. But Samsara meant that question in a different way, for he understood that Sky City was his breaking point and that he knows a way to reverse and undo the Plutonian's atrocities.